आई होप यू गाइस आर एबल टू सी मी एंड हियर मी। थोड़ा सा ना मुझे चैट सेक्शन में बताते चलना, तो इज देयर एनीबडी नॉट कंफर्टेबल विद हिंदी, देन आई विल गो इन इंग्लिश। इफ एवरीबडी इज कंफर्टेबल इन हिंदी देन आई विल गो इन हिंदी। यू कैन टेल मी इन द चैट। So shall I continue in English or Hindi? Oh, if anybody is there who does not understand Hindi, then Hindi should not be a preferred language. Okay, fine. So I believe few people are there who only understand English. So guys, this is a introductory session of the sort. Okay. In which I am going to discuss with you regarding the preparation strategy. So first of all, tell me among you guys, how many are preparing for GATE 21 and how many are preparing for 22, so that I get to know what is the distribution exactly.
GATE 21.
Anybody for 22? Because then only we'll discuss strategy. Harshit is there. 2022. Okay then. Then let us go through the strategy part for both the cases. Okay. I think there used to be a whiteboard of this sort in Zoom. So can anybody tell me if there is a whiteboard feature here?
व्हाइट बोर्ड
है ना। तो सबसे पहले लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट इज This is, I think, not exactly whiteboard. Draw. Select stamp.
Provision.
Yeah, now it is working fine. So GATE 2021 first of all, है ना? So roughly how many days we have left? Days left. This month there are 11 days, then 31, then 31. Around 73. So we can roughly estimate around 80 days, है ना? So if there are 80 days when we talk about the GATE exam. Then what can we do in these 80 days? So first thing is revision must be a priority. Okay, revision must always be a priority in the last few days. Now the thing is, how will you guys revise? You can use the practice questions uploaded by an academy. You can use class notes. You can use crash course. This is the best method of revision. You will get new questions as well, and you will interact with educators to discuss your doubts. Along with that, you must attend the doubt clearing batch. You must know that every week we have 3 sessions for doubt clearing that you can attend. So that is how you will revise. So basically, the 3 elements that will be most important will be this one, and this one. Okay. So like right now, what I'll assume is for GATE 2021, if I assume you have the entire day, assuming entire day is available, even if it is not available, I believe you need to make time. Because in the last 2 months, we can't go with any excuses. Okay. So, like, you can dedicate around 4 to 6 hours to crash course. Okay. 2 hours for problems, practice, and like 1 hour for doubts. Okay. Then what you can do is, if some subjects are left, leftover syllabus, this thing you can do like 2 to 3 hours per day. So what I would expect from you guys is around 8 to 10 hour effort daily. Okay. This is the thing that you need to do if you want to really achieve somewhere around under 100 or under 500 rank, depending upon your potential. So right now, these things are very, very necessary. Okay. Then what you can do, like Sunday, you can dedicate for tests. This can include like the free test series, all India level test series that is running. Okay. If any educator is taking weekly quiz, that you should also give. Okay. Other than that, plus test series. So first, what I would like to take is any queries that you have related to GATE 2021 prep. Okay. Anything that you would like to ask, then we'll move to the GATE 2022 part. Anybody can say anything that you like to ask? Anyone? You guys can unmute yourself and you can ask me. It is not necessary that you need to write in the chat. Whenever I want you to write in the chat, I'll tell you clearly. It is an open session, discussion session. You can ask whatever you want to. Okay. This sort of feature is only available for Iconic users. So you should make the most of it.
Sir, if someone has completed some particular subject by himself, should he also attend the comprehensive course, or the practice sessions is enough for that particular subject?
If you have already attended a comprehensive course, right?
No, sir. I have I have done networks by myself.
Okay.
I had the materials of Ace Academy and everything like that. Uh-huh. So I have studied.
So, Udra, what I would suggest is, like right now, you should prioritize crash course. If you are able to solve the problems after attending crash course, it is sufficient. See, never ever judge yourself based on what other teachers are teaching. Whatever they might be teaching, if you are able to solve questions from any subject, then you are fine. If you are not able to, then you need help. As simple as that. Be very objective. Even if it is my subject, what I would totally tell you is, tomorrow I am starting power electronics. If you already understand, if you already are able to solve the problems, no need to waste your time with me, because I'll be taking it from the very basic. So the students who are already in the advanced stage of preparation, their time will be wasted in a basic course, right? So right now, if you want to start a new subject whose basics are clear, go for crash course rather than comprehensive.
Okay,
sir. Thank you. Okay. Anybody else? Any such sort of doubt? I believe someone was asking like how to utilize test series. Okay. So let us see. 1 minute. Can we add pages to it? I don't think so. You guys can take a screenshot if you want to, then I'll delete it because I don't think pages feature is there. Anybody who wants can take a screenshot.
Sir, it's okay. Getting recorded. We'll share the recording with them later on.
Okay, sure. So now the question was about the test series. Okay. See, right now, since we have already crossed mid of November, what I would tell you guys is focus more on subject test. See, there are three categories: subject test, mixed test, and mock test. Don't go for part test now, hai na? जैसे कि पार्ट टेस्ट, इफ इन अ पार्ट टेस्ट आई एम आस्किंग अ सर्टेन चैप्टर, दैट वोंट बेनिफिट यू एट ऑल एट दिस स्टेज ऑफ प्रिपरेशन. सो दिस सब्जेक्ट टेस्ट शुड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ रिवीजन. लाइक व्हेनेवर रिवीजन इज कंप्लीटेड, अटेम्प्ट टेस्ट. ओके, सिंपल. Then, if you have completed the revision of 2 through 3 subjects, okay, if you have already completed revision of 2 to 3 subjects, then I would suggest that you give mixed test. Okay, like tomorrow I myself am starting mixed test. Okay, and somehow me and Vishal sir might also be taking some such things. You can go for it. And you can start like mock test somewhere around, what I would say, after mid of December. And even if you start in January, then also fine. But target around 25 mock test. Okay. And the approach in attempting any test is basically a 3-step approach, what I would say. What are the 3 steps? First is attempt a test, then analyze the test. Okay, test analysis will be done by your coaches. Then revise whatever are your weaknesses, then again attempt the test. Okay. Attempt the next test, not you don't need to attempt the same test. So this cycle should go on whenever you are giving test, and this will lead to continuous improvement. This is a cycle that will lead to continuous improvement. Okay, it is very necessary. Any other thing GATE 2021 aspirants would like to know? And this is applicable for even GATE 2022. This thing you have to do next year. Anybody?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I'm currently studying third year, sir. So is it better to give a try for 21 and a full length for 22? A suggestion, sir.
So basically what I would suggest is, yaar dekho, you have 2 opportunities, 21 and 22. So don't waste this 21 opportunity. Whatever you can do, give your best. Because if you get free in February after GATE 2021, still you have 12 months to prepare for GATE 22. Hai na? So if you keep a very long-term vision for GATE 2022, right now 15 months or 12 months won't make much of a difference. But somehow, if you are able to increase your marks in GATE 2021, that will be a huge confidence booster when you go into 22. Because confidence will also play a major role. Right?
Yes, sir.
So try and increase your marks anyhow, like preparing 2-3 subjects which are very important, which have high weightage. Anyhow, you have to like get 50-60 marks. If you do that, then it will seem more possible to get 80 marks in the next year. That would seem easier.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah.
Should someone attend a test series without preparation to check the pattern?
No. See, never ever attempt a test without revision. because like are you aiming to crack GATE without studying in January?
No.
You will be going prepared na. So if you are going to give the actual exam after revising everything, what is the use of giving a test without revising anything? Hai na? Like suppose if I am teaching a subject, I always have to follow my notes. Then why would I attempt to teach without them when I know for the lifetime I have to follow that process? I would try something that you are not going to do in the actual exam.
So how much is sufficient for giving a mock test, sir? How much?
Basically, I would say if you are prepared for 80 marks, you can start giving mock test. But evaluate your performance in those 80 marks. Like suppose you have not prepared digital and analog, so don't count their marks at all. Like basically calculate your marks out of 80. How many are you getting? If out of 80 you are only getting 40 or 50, that means that 80 itself is not well prepared. Why to chase the remaining 20 when I don't know the 80 marks paper? Hai na? That way you have to think. If someone is preparing for like 70 marks, so they have to basically check their paper again and evaluate how many marks are they getting out of 70.
And sir, one more suggestion about mathematics. Should it be done continuously for every day, 1 or 2 hours? Mathematics.
Arre, right now, what I would suggest is, na, attend mathematics crash course or any short-term course. After that, you can give 1 hour daily for practice, not more than that. Like 1 month for December, if you complete the crash course in November, 1 month for December, you can reserve it for maths. January for aptitude practice like that. Yeah, na? So after maths, replace it with aptitude and give it on a daily basis. And once you reach this stage, mock test, a maths and apti will be revised in every mock test. So you won't need to revise them separately. Yeah, na? Mock tests are the best way to revise. So you can either attempt maths and aptitude test also for revision. That is also fine. Even if you don't practice anything. Yeah, na? Should we focus? I think I have answered this. Focus on perfecting some subject or try to cover all subject medium level. Like the only aim should be to get more marks. Okay. So 100% syllabus completion is not necessary to get more marks. You should focus on like getting more marks from the subjects that you can easily prepare. Because if 1 or 2 subjects, 3 subjects are left, they can be prepared before 22. But if you like prepare for 70 marks and you actually get 50, 55 out of that, that would boost your confidence. Like 70 marks, I know very well. I just need to target the remaining 30 marks. So that should be the strategy for 22. Okay. I think this is fine. So now let's move on to the 22 part. Okay. So for GATE 2022, right now, what you can do is first is focus on maximizing. Score for GATE 21. How can you do this? Like you need to prepare maths, apti, network, control. I'm telling the easy ones. Okay. Maths, apti, network, control. Other than that, you can prepare like power electronics,
digital.
डिजिटल हैज अ लो वेटेज ना, तो उसको प्रिपेयर करके क्या मिलेगा? वेटेज भी तो होना चाहिए सब्जेक्ट का. एंड देन लाइक डिजिटल एनालॉग यू कैन लीव इफ यू आर टारगेटिंग 22.
ईएमटी सर,
ईएमटी आल्सो हैज लो वेटेज. आइदर मशीन और पावर सिस्टम, है ना? इफ यू इवन कवर सम यूनिट्स, नॉट द एंटायर सब्जेक्ट, then also fine, hai na? Even if you don't cover the entire subject. Signal is a bit typical. Yes, signals can be done. Signals also has a good weightage. But if you are good at it, then go for it. Otherwise, leave it. So I'll say optional. Hai na? Then what you can do is, enroll in some GATE 2022 batch. We will roll out new batches for GATE 2022 in December. Okay. December new batches will come. So you can enroll in that. Hai na? If you know some subject very well, like network, if someone is very good at it, then attend its crash course. Hai na? So that way you have to go, like for the next 2 months. The next 2 months, what I would say, one or two subject preparation you need to go about, and more revision. Okay. Then what you can do is take a week's break post GATE 21 and then again start preparing. Understood? Because I know you will be exhausted, you will be tired. So you can enjoy for 1 week and then again you can come back and complete your syllabus. So I see Shivani posted one question. Let me check that out. How much practice is required for GATE 21 for final year students? Shivani, see, I won't quantify the number of questions that you have to do because that always varies from student to student. Like when I was preparing, when I prepared network, I did not need much practice. I was good at it. But with control systems, I needed practice. With signal system, I needed practice. So that always depends, like how many questions you need to solve so that you can solve the new questions. Like suppose if someone solves a previous year book and after that they are able to score well in the test series. So that means they are on the right track. They need not practice anymore. But if someone solves previous year as well as practice questions on Unacademy as well as on DPP also, and still they are not able to get marks, that means that much practice is not sufficient. And also I focus more on quality of practice rather than quantity. Like if you are learning from each and every question, then quality is very, very good and your education level, preparation level will keep on increasing. But if I'm seeing a question, I'm thinking for a minute and then I'm checking the solution, then my preparation level is not increasing. I'm static. Then even if you practice 1,000 questions, they will not be enough. That sort of a thing will happen. So make sure when any of you are practicing in the right manner, you are giving your 100% or even more than 100% to a question, and then only you check its correct solution. So if you give up very easily, then what will happen? When you see a question in GATE exam and it is out of your reach, you will immediately give up. And once you give up, you will not be able to solve it. So we have to inculcate a habit among ourselves that we need to fight with the question. Can you mute, Pankaj? Can you mute a bit? So you need to fight with each and every question and then only you will gain that sort of a knowledge which is required for getting good marks in the exam. Is that clear, Shivani? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So anything else anybody wants to ask? I think I have given a fair idea about 21 and 22. Any particular thing that you'd like to ask? Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. Sir, how to manage both college hours and preparation hours, sir?
Okay. So basically, my dear friend, what I would suggest is don't delay your college preparation till the time the exams come. Like many students are there in the college who buy the guides, jisko hum Hindi mein kunji kehte hain. These sort of books you will buy when the exam arrives. And that time you will have to halt your GATE preparation. So what I did during my college days is, on a daily basis, I used to prepare for college as well. So that way I used to score well in the mid-semester exam, end semester exam. Like daily, sometime I kept it reserved for college. So what you guys can do, anyways, you are attending college classes, you are attending college to mark your attendance. Why don't you dedicate that time to the college exam preparation? If you do that, then the hours that are right now being wasted, they will actually give you good marks in the college exams. And then the rest of the time that you get in your hostel, in your room, anywhere, that can be dedicated to gate preparation. So never ever prepare for college exams at the last moment if you want to do well in the competitive exams. Take them side by side. If some lecture is like some lecture is not being conducted in college, that time could be dedicated to preparing one or the other topic that will be asked in the college exam that way. Okay. But if you are doing well in the college exams, na, that the only way to do well in the college exam is regular study. And if you are studying regularly, you will never ever feel the pressure when the exams will arrive. Okay. So basically, guys, if you really want to be successful in your college, like I got a CGPA of 9.85, as well as I got single digit rank in GATE with my college. So I believe the student who is walking on the right path, na, that is not getting deviated, seeing others, ki baki logo ko dekha, and we are just preparing in the last moment. So those sort of student will never be able to do well in the college or in the competitive exam. But the students who are taking both of the things, both the exams side by side, they'll be able to do well in both cases. Okay. So rare cases, you will find someone who is a college topper, who is doing exceptionally well and who fails miserably at GATE. That those sort of cases are rare. So you need to be good at both the cases. Next question. And Rishabh has written assignment and test. Mere bhai dekho, assignments you guys are not doing yourself. So don't give me this assignment project. All of these you are anyhow like fooling the college authorities. So you can do that. Aditya is saying he faces the concepts quite well. So Aditya, see, if you are a diploma student, what I would say is you are weak at the basic mathematics. Okay. So you need to attend a certain course either on an academy or on YouTube, wherever you want to, that teaches the basic differentiation, basic integration, those sort of skills. Because nobody is bad at numericals. It is only about who gives up when. If someone gives up very quickly, then they'll not be able to solve numerical. If someone fights with a question, they give their everything, then sooner or later they'll become good at it. As simple as that. But what happens if my mathematics part is not good? Then I get afraid when I see subjects like signals, controls, they are totally mathematical. I will get really, really afraid. But what diploma students are good at, they are generally good at concepts. Because in diploma, you have read a lot of theory. You have read a lot of concepts. So you find your comfort zone there. But actual exam requires numerical solving ability. So you have to come out of that comfort zone and start solving more problems. And the first step towards it would be to learn the basic mathematics required. And then your confidence will be boosted that yes, you can compete with the people who have gone through that 10 plus 2 stage, who have failed that JEE exam. You can also compete with them. Okay, Aditya? Have I answered your query?
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello, sir. Rajoshi, I'm asking something on behalf of my learner, Shivani. She was unable to put her doubt directly to you. Actually, she started preparing for the 2021 around a week back in Iconic. She's asked me that she has a lot of subjects to cover and the time is quite less. I couldn't suggest her to join all comprehensive courses, but I suggested her to join the subjects you mentioned, network, aptitude, maths, control, plus power electronics, these five at present. After that, let's wait 1 month where you are, then I will go to the next step. This is what I suggested. how can
that I is ask... fine. Like she can prepare if she is absolutely zero in every subject. Then I believe she should go for GATE 2022 directly rather than focusing on GATE 21.
Actually, today she asked a question which made me suspect that there are some shortcomings, because the difference between why are we using concept of impedance in why are we adding reactances like resistances instead of capacitors? This was a question I got. So I was feeling that there is some lack, very basic conceptual.
Yeah, that is what I'm saying. If she is lacking in basic, she should focus on 22. But if some subjects basic are clear, then she can prepare via crash course and she can do this. One or two subject preparation and revision.
Now, should I tell her to maximize marks for GATE 20 or 21 for now?
I don't think so, because if her basics are missing, then that would be a demotivating step for her if she doesn't score well. Like suppose if she is able to get 25 to 30 marks and she somehow does not qualify the exam, that would be a very, very demotivating step for her. So you have to judge her preparation level. And if she can qualify the exam, that can be a confidence booster. And if you feel she cannot qualify the exam, then give her a long-term strategy for 22.
That is okay, sir. So I have to judge first and then we didn't get much time to judge. All right. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Anybody else? Acha, in the meantime, you guys can tell me, do you find this sort of a session helpful? Because I have seen not many people have asked me, only hardly 4 or 5 students have asked me something. If you are getting personal time of an educator, you should utilize it, no, actually.
Yes, this is very helpful.
Because to be honest, guys, like we are planning a lot of stuff in Iconic, but only if you guys actively participate, then such initiatives would be successful. Na? Otherwise, if you guys only hesitate in going forward with that, then that planning itself fails. So right now you are a bunch of only a few students. You can get a lot of personal guidance. You can get a lot of personal attention. So make sure that you take the maximum benefit out of it and get the best rank possible, and like create an impact, leave a mark behind and tell everybody, like, since we got this sort of a support, we have made use of it. Because if you don't make use of it, then it is wasting such a good opportunity. Not every student is privileged enough to get such a sort of interaction with the educators or the personal coaches. Hai na? So you guys are in a very, very good position. And this time, I would want, at least if you guys are 20 students or something, I would want at least 2 or 3 of you in the top 100. Okay. If that happens, then it would really be revolutionary. That would only indicate one thing, that whatever hard work we are doing for you guys, that is becoming fruitful. Right? So we really have high hopes from the students in Iconic as well as Plus. But definitely Iconic students will get more effort from our side as compared to Plus. And Plus will get more effort than YouTube. So you guys have to justify that as well. Right? So feel free to reach out to your coaches whenever you need any guidance. And such sessions will also be happening frequently. Yeah, Rudra. Yeah, first Rudra, let Rudra ask Sai, then I'll come to you.
Sir, actually, I have got a placement right now in a company named HLS Asia. So it's I have an opportunity for the next 10 days. Should I sign it or should I leave it?
So basically, if you sign it in 10 days, then only you will be eligible. Otherwise, you'll have to leave everything.
Yes, sir.
And what package are they offering?
Sir, it's 8 lakh rupees and plus incentive, it will go up to 13 lakhs.
Okay. So Rudra, to be honest, I would suggest that you sign the agreement. And you like prepare for GATE simultaneously, because what happens when you have a backup with yourself, then you are way more confident in giving the examination as compared to when everything is on the line. when everything is on the line and you panic even for one moment in the exam, then that entire exam goes waste. Hai na? So it would be a struggle. It would be a struggle for the next 2 months, surely. But the day when you are appearing for exam, you will be a lot more confident than you will be as compared to when you leave that job. Okay. So no doubt you have to like reduce your sleep, reduce your comfort for the next 2 months, but that could be more fruitful. So if you are ready to go through that struggle, like sleeping 4-5 hours each day and managing gate preparation along with the job, then it is fine. If you can't do that, then I would suggest choose one of the two, whatever your parents will support, because they are the biggest stakeholders in your career. If I tell you prepare for gate, like, see, if you don't get a rank, I won't lose anything personally. Hai na? Who will lose the most is your parents, is your family. So they should be the ones to take this decision along with you, whether you should go for job or skip that opportunity and give your 100% to gate. Hai na? They would be the best advisors in this case. But if you can manage both by cutting out the sleep, your comfort, then I believe you should take up the job and prepare for gate simultaneously. Krishna, if you are in third year, first semester, that means you are in fifth semester. I believe still you have almost 1.5 years to prepare for gate. Yes, you can pick up whatever subjects you are studying in the semesters, focus on that and prepare them up to the gate and ESC level. Okay. Like complete the entire theory, complete the entire numericals. So that will fetch you good marks in the college exam as well as the gate and ESC. Nikhilesh, what I would suggest is how to handle pressure. Yeah, dekho, never ever count the number of days, count the amount of work you can do in these days. Like suppose if I have 60 days and I commit to myself, like I'll give 10 hours each day, that amounts to 600 hours. Remove the buffer part, at least 500 hours you can do. Hai na? If you can put in 500 hours and you can divide those hours into various things, like these many hours for revision, these many hours for subject completion, then you can achieve a lot of things. So if you monitor your daily routine and you manage your time very, very well, then you can make the most out of these last 2 months. Okay. So whatever happens, whether you get a good rank or you don't get such a good rank, but wherever you are right now, you should focus on becoming way better than this in the next 2 months. If you are able to achieve that, then you will feel very, very good about yourself. You will feel very confident after you give the gate exam. So focus on that. Like if you are standing at 30 marks right now and you can promise yourself that I'll reach 60 marks, that sort of an improvement is really, really commendable. Yes, Sai, maths and network would be the perfect point to start electrical engineering. Very good. Good thought. Anybody else?
Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, is there any much difference in syllabus between the gate and ESC?
Yes, there is a slight difference between the syllabus of gate and ESC. So like whenever you are attending any subject, like suppose I'm starting power electronics tomorrow, I'll explain the difference in the syllabus of gate for power electronics in gate and ESC. If you watch my first lecture of machines, you will get to know the difference between the syllabus of machines in gate and ESC, like that. So every educator takes the first session as a introductory session. There you will get to know the syllabus difference. And even quickly, what you can do, either you can ask your personal coach or you yourself can Google both the syllabus, keep them side by side. You'll get to know the difference. That would be the best way to judge, rather than asking anybody, na, because they'll tell based on their thought. But whatever is written in that official syllabus, that is actually a part of syllabus.
And the means, sir, way of asking questions, it will be similar, no, sir?
Basically, what I would say is in the question part, ESE majorly focuses on easy questions, but in large number, more questions will be there in exam. Gate will have less questions, but more difficult. That is the major difference.
Yes. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Difficulty level varies.
Yes. Okay, sir.
Okay. So I think we are fine. So let us wind it up here. And guys, give whatever you can, give your best shot in this year or the next year gate. Really, many people have joined very early, and that is a good sign, like Sai. So that way, if you are aware right now and you are willing to give your 100% for the next 2-3 years, you will definitely get a good rank. But make sure you don't get demotivated and continue your preparation at the same tempo that you have started. And only pick up the tempo from here on. Pick up the hard work that you are doing. Don't decrease it. Rather than that, increase it. Okay. So it was nice interacting with all of you. Really, I enjoyed. So guys, at last, I would like to say, let's crack it and let's get the top ranks in this year gate and make proud our parents, our families, our relatives, everybody in our life. Let us make them proud and let us leave a mark in gate 2021. So let's do it. Okay. Thank you, everybody.